Hi, kia ora, namaste. We've got a jam-packed episode for you. We end our time on the North Island of New Zealand for now, and we explore Nga Manu Nature Reserve just off of State Highway 1. We check out some awesome free attractions around the capital and enjoy some picturesque freedom camps before heading to an absolute gem in the city, Zealandia. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe. We had a lovely wander around Whanganui, a great town with loads of cool shops, galleries and cafes. Check out episode 53 for a more in-depth look at this must-visit place.
Thai green curry at the Gibbos.
That evening, we headed over to our mates for a night of good food, great company and lots of laughs. Thanks for having us. We have just arrived at Nga Manu Nature Reserve. We drove back a couple of hours this morning from our mates in Whanganui. We had a lovely evening, didn't we?
Yeah.
Nga Manu is a 14 hectare nature reserve, loads of native birds, native reptiles. You can do guided tours, have ranger experiences. And we've got a beautiful day. Really windy on the way here, weren't it? A lot of crosswind intervention assist stuff came on the dash, but that's okay. Just gonna have a spot of lunch and then we'll go check it out.
Kaupapa, rooted in the Trust's goals to preserve and enhance native forests so that their inhabitants can flourish. Since inception, Nga Manu has partnered with DOC and others in many breed for release programmes which seek to re-establish at-risk species of birds and reptiles into the wild. So it's just off the State Highway 1, coming to or from Wellington, and yeah, we definitely recommend it. It's, there's a lovely trail that you can do through the forest, and the bird song is amazing. And yeah, there's eels, kaka, loads of different birds and insects and lizards, different enclosures. Yeah, we just did a...
Wave, she's waving.
How funny.
Oh, she's showing off all her teddies. Give me a teddy, quick, from the top, quick. Just some random lady in a motorhome. We just pulled up and just waved at each other, and she started showing us all her teddies.
That's strange.
We're a weird bunch, us motorhomers, aren't we?
Yeah.
We're a bit weird.
It's nice when they wave back, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, I wonder where she's going.
I've lost my train of thought now. Yeah, we just did a self-guided thing, and it was nice just exploring, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And now we're heading to Wellington. Drink holders, foldable drink holders from Burns Go, $10. And I just put a load of sticky back tape on the back. You meant to drill them or screw them in, but this is just fine. And then just...
Oh my god. We have recently woken up here at Ngāti Toa Domain, and we've had, what, three beautiful nights here?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Tommy.
Hello.
We've just been absolutely chilling, because since we tied the knot, we've been non-stop. So we've had 3 days just relaxing, not doing any filming, not really doing anything at all. It's Sunday morning here, so it's busy, because you've got all the kids' games and that. Yesterday they did some rugby as well, and all these kids are doing the haka, it was really nice. And then today we're heading to the Beehive, aren't we?
Yeah.
We're gonna go on a tour of the Parliament, which sounds boring, but it won't be. We find stuff like that quite interesting, don't we?
Yeah, it'd be good. Hey, so we just got to like the Beehive area, and we're gonna do a tour of the Beehive, which is like, I think it's like the government building in New Zealand. Just show you. There it is. Pretty cool. Yeah, it's a free tour that you can do, isn't it?
Yeah. But we're lost at the moment, so let's concentrate.
Okay. We need to get there. Hey, so we've just finished our tour, and it was better than I thought. It's not actually just the Beehive. There's three buildings you go into.
You weren't allowed to take any photos.
No.
Or anything.
Yeah.
Which is weird, because a lot of the rooms we saw go on TV anyway.
Yeah. Would have been good to get some footage, but that's all right. But the buildings are beautiful, aren't they?
Yeah, I'm glad we came.
The tour's just quite simple, going through different rooms and that.
But it's free, isn't it? So.
Yeah. No, it's definitely worth a stop. And we've sat in rooms that the Queen and the... all the prime ministers have been in, which is pretty cool.
Bread pakora things, potato.
Yeah, stuffed spices.
Nice.
Yeah.
What a view, eh? Heading to a must visit in the capital, the Museum of New Zealand. Free for the public and great on a rainy day. We were so keen to check out Gallipoli, the Scale of War exhibition, which we first heard about whilst visiting the Weta workshop.
After a real intense experience with these giant lifelike sculptures and stories from the war, we explored the rest of this amazing and interactive place, waiting for the weather to clear.
We are once again at Evans Bay Freedom Camp in Wellington. Matilda parked up, Tommy's just getting ready. Look at this beautiful day. Speaking to some friends and whānau up north near Auckland, and apparently the weather is shocking, but we have just been lucky as. I don't think we've really had any bad days. We're just waiting, basically, to get on the ferry over to Te Waipounamu. And today we are heading to Zealandia, which we've been wanting to go to for a long time, and should be awesome.
After checking in and having a wander around the great gift shop, we met up with our guide Paula, who gave us a great introduction into Zealandia and what our tour would entail, before watching an informative video and then heading on in. Love it.
Really cool. We've just left our tour guide Paula, who is so nice, and she's a volunteer and was just amazing.
Yeah, there's like 500 volunteers here or something. Crazy.
So we started the tour with her, and she said at any point if you want, just let her know and you can go off and do your own thing. Definitely when you come in, do the tour, and then you can stay on afterwards as well.
Yeah, you get a lot more information and a lot more out of it.
Yeah, so she knows all the hot spots of where birds and that are.
Yeah, that's true. Ooh. We've seen loads of birds, haven't we, as well?
Yeah, I don't even know what we've seen. Loads of stuff. Yeah. It's like they've got a 500-year plan to make this area, this fenced-off area, what it used to be before people ruined everything. And even though we're standing on this dam, if you go out into the bush a bit, it actually feels ancient, doesn't
it? They've done an amazing job.
And it's right in Wellington. It's in the capital city.
Yeah, it's like a 10-minute drive. Definitely a must-do.
Yeah, and if you're lucky, you'll get Paula on your tour because she was wonderful. Really good. Of blank CDs from an op shop in Masterton because I wanted to do our mums back in the UK a few blank CDs.
They just came like this, like in their own case.
In their own boxes,
and we've just been going through them and got to the back one and it made me laugh so hard. This is what we found.
That's porn, a porn DVD basically. We just found in random second-hand what we thought were blank CDs from an op shop in Masterton. So if you run an op shop out there, check your blank CDs.
Hey!
Yay!
So we've been to VTNZ and we passed.
Our first waff since we've owned Matilda, and with our all-terrain tyres as well. Passed absolutely fine. The only thing was
front rotor brake will need replacing at some point.
But that wasn't, it was just a what's the word?
Recommendation or something like that.
Yeah. She passed! So yeah, we're happy.
Yeah, so that's sorted for another year.
Yay!
So yeah, we're heading towards Wellington now. We're just going to stay at Freedom Camp, and then tomorrow, hopefully, we'll catch the ferry over.
Weather depending. Toa from Twizel, and they gave us these, which they made, Ali and Phil, really, really nice. And these, oh my goodness, I wish you could smell. How good they smell. Thank you.
Hey, just gone for a morning run into like the little valley here. It's beautiful. Can't really run though because it's a bit dangerous, so I'm going to go back out onto the beach. And this morning we're headed on the Inter-Islander ferry to the South Island. Oh, can't wait. Yeah, we're on our way to the ferry. Had a lovely night, can't remember what it's called.
No, it's quite a long name, put it in.
We'll put it in. It's beautiful there, really rugged. And yeah, we're just gonna catch ferry across. So it takes a few hours, doesn't it?
Yeah, I think it's about 4.5 hours. And we've just called them and checked about the weather conditions because there was a few warnings in, but it all seems sweet.
Yeah.
And we've got the lounge, so we'll get food and drinks on board, which is nice.
That'll be nice.
And that's the end of our time on the North Island for the time being.
Yeah, it's been 3 years here.
On the North, yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
So, but we're really looking forward to seeing the South Island again.
Yeah, it's been way too long. We'll go down south to get some air.
It's our favourite island.
So we've been waiting now for what, an hour?
Yeah.
To get on the ferry.
More than an hour.
So if you're planning on doing this, don't do what we do and think, oh, let's get here a bit earlier, because it don't make a blind bit of difference.
It's alright.
If you're in a motorhome where you got gas, they give you this, and you have to hang this in your window, and you have to make sure that your LPG is turned off. We were lucky enough to go into the premium lounge, which we totally recommend. Food and drink included, it's lovely, quiet and peaceful. Great, especially if you're like me and aren't keen on sailing. Thanks for watching. See you soon.